So I want to do one example of implicit differentiation with logs. So that we see how that works. We first discussed implicit differentiation back in chapter 2, and I want to now bring it in now that we've discovered the derivative of log. So I want to work this example problem, which is to find, let's see, it says find a y prime using implicit differentiation for this relationship, and I have 4x plus natural log of x squared y to the fourth is equal to 10. Okay? Okay, so now we want to do this, and so we see how this x and y have a relationship together. If I put a number in for x, I could solve and figure out what y was. But it's easier to differentiate this implicitly. So I differentiate each piece. This piece, let's call that piece 1, this one piece 2, and this one piece 3. And I'll do those. And let's take piece 1 and 3. I think you're comfortable differentiating those. So the derivative of 1, right? Derivative of 4x is just 4, right? And piece 3, derivative of, derivative, I'm spelling the wrong word here, of 10 is just 0, okay? So now we want to do piece 2, which is more complicated. The derivative of natural log x squared y to the fourth. So this is an example of where I have, and I just want to say this, this is natural log of some function g of x. And when I have this and I want to differentiate this, let's call this f of x. Is this? So when I want to take the derivative of this, it's 1 over g of x times g prime of x, right? And we can also write that as g prime of x divided by g of x. Multiply that in there, okay? So in this particular function, my g of x is this inside piece, x squared. So for us, g of x is x squared y to the fourth power. Okay, so now I need to, in order to just use this formulation for natural log, I just need to find what is g prime of x. Okay, and g prime of x, I need to use the product rule. So this gets, I mean, all of these rules come into play. So here we go. My first piece is x squared, and the derivative of that is 2x. And you can call these uv, right? This is u prime if you want. First, second, however you want to keep these. And the derivative straight in your mind. But I don't use f and g again because I already used them, right? So that's a little bit confusing. But so when I want to put these together, I have x squared, and the derivative of that is 2x. I have y to the fourth. Derivative of y to the fourth is 4y cubed. And then I have to take the derivative of this inside piece. This is the implicit differentiation piece right there, y prime. Okay? So anytime I'm taking the derivative of something with respect to y, I have to have this y prime. Okay, so now, and then in this uv, setup, I have the product rule that looks like this. Just the first one times the derivative of the second, and then the second times the derivative of the first, right? So I have x squared times 4y cubed times y prime plus y to the fourth times 2x. So let me write this out. So I might write this more 4x squared y cubed and then y prime plus 2xy to the fourth. I probably will write that. Now, let's keep track. That's my g prime of x, okay? I still haven't put it into the derivative for, go back up. See, I'm trying to put it in right here, okay? So now let's find, if I name this, this is my f of x. So I'll go back in. So here again, my f of x piece is this piece that looks like natural log of x squared y to the fourth, right? And I know that f prime of x is, if this thing is g of x, 1 over g of x times g prime of x, or that's g prime of x over g of x, okay? And I have my g prime right here, right? So here is this piece that I need to put in right, oops, not in there. That goes right here. And then my original g is right here, right? Right here, goes right here, okay? So let me put that in so we can see what it looks like. So f prime of x is equal to, and I'm going to put g prime, 4x squared y cubed y prime plus 2xy to the fourth, all over g of x, which is x squared y to the fourth. Okay? Now, I want to go back up and to my original problem, return to that. These are longer problems. Returning to this 4x plus natural log x squared y to the fourth equal 10. Okay, so now this is my derivative here, and I'll put it in blue. The derivative of 4x we said was 4. The derivative of this piece is right here, 4x squared y cubed y prime plus 2xy to the fourth over x squared y to the fourth, and then the derivative of 10 is 0. Okay, now that is most of the heavy lifting. I still have to solve for that piece right there in red, the y prime. So I'll start by moving this 4 to the other side. So I have 4x squared. This is a lot of algebra. And you just want to go slowly and intentionally. Negative 4. Okay. Now the next thing I probably want to do is multiply both sides by this denominator. It'll cancel on this side and I'll get it over here. So I get 4x squared y cubed y prime 2xy to the fourth is equal to negative 4x squared y to the fourth. Okay. If you see this right here, right, I have now this y prime that I'm still looking for. So I'm still trying to do that. So maybe I'll move this piece over, just subtract that from both sides since it's added to my y prime piece. So I get 4x squared y cubed y prime is equal to negative 4x squared y to the fourth minus 2xy to the fourth. Okay. And finally, this is still what I'm looking for right here in red. So I'm here now, and at this point, this is multiplied by this quantity, 4x squared y cubed. So if I divide both sides by that, I should get y prime by itself. So here I have y prime is equal to, and then I'll put all of this on the other side, the original right-hand side, and now divided by 4x squared y cubed. You should be able to simplify this by factoring out a greatest common factor, so let's look at that. So y prime is equal to, let's see, on top I have a negative 2. Oops, I need to take out a little bit more. I have an x and I have a y to the fourth power. Okay, and when I take that out, I'm left with 2x, and then plus, and I have a 2xy to the fourth, plus 1. Okay, and then down here I have a 4x squared y cubed, right? So when I look at this, the 2 will cancel with the 4 and leave me a 2 in the denominator. This x will cancel one of these x's in the denominator and leave me with 1. And the y to the 4th will leave me with no y's in the denominator, or you can also think about these as exponent rules. But I should get negative y 2x plus 1. So it's significantly simpler once you simplify this. Okay? Okay, let me know if you have questions.